You know, Dan, you and I, we met once before. You won't remember it, but you made a great impression on me, how kind a man you were. When you were working at another network, at ESPN, you came and did a Sunday night conversation with Mr. Ibo. And I was
Oh, my goodness.
And you were so kind. You kind of hung out with me and a couple of the guys at Eskimo Joe's, and I was working for Leonard Hamilton at the time. And you were so kind. And so to every person that you met, and what a great person you are in this profession, what you've done for sports. But I appreciate the opportunity to visit with you, you know, 30 years later, whatever. It's a group to 29 years later, whatever. But I appreciate it.
That's
made quite an impression upon me, and I appreciate you doing something on Mr. Ibo.
Yeah, Hank Ibo was this basketball legend. He was the coach of the U.S. Olympic team that lost to the Russians. And I just didn't want him to be thought of as the coach who lost to the Russians, lost the gold medal game. And he was, you know, this unbelievable figure. And I went out and did a Sunday conversation with him. I think we played basketball at Iba Gallagher Arena. We had a pickup basketball.
Yeah.
And also when we went to Eskimo Joe's, which was the bar in town, I think I went with Mike Gundy there and Coach Pat Jones. Does that sound?
That's right.
And I remember we were doing shots of 151 rum, and the bar caught on fire, and nobody was concerned that the bar caught on fire that day. How's my memory there, Coach?
Pretty good. I mean, it's Oklahoma. Eventually in the cold or something's going to, the wind's going to blow in the other direction, or, that's how it's supposed to be. And there was a young assistant coach by the name of Bill Self, Leonard's staff at that time, who kind of made some of himself. I don't know if you know that or not.
Yeah, he seems to have. You've gone through an awful lot, though, Kyle. The story with Oklahoma State, the plane crash, and, you're an assistant for a long, long time, and you get this opportunity. So, congrats to you, because this is a business of persevering and being told no, probably. But, it's a big win, and I know you got to the tournament. I think you played Texas Tech last year, right?
Yeah, it's been fun. Yeah, we've had a lot of fun. We're the winningest program in the state. We've had a lot of fun the last decade. So,
all right, if you wake up, you might have to be reminded that you beat Duke last night, okay? So when you wake up, just have your wife say, yes, you did beat Duke last night.
I will. Thank you.
Thanks
for having me on.
Thank you, Kyle. And I mentioned Coach Keller. He was in Stillwater, and there was the plane crash that killed 10 players. And I think he wears a pin that says, has the number 10 on it to remember those players. He was going to be on the plane that crashed. And his coach, Eddie Sutton, said, I want you to switch and be on the plane that's faster. I want you to get back and break down film. Now, I'm sort of just taking this from memory. But there was Coach Keller's cousin, whose last name was Fleming. He replaced Coach Keller on the plane last minute, and that plane crashed. So this is his cousin, Nate Fleming, changes seats with him so he can get back to Stillwater to break down film. And that was, early morning in 2001. And, he's lived with that. He thinks about that every day. And I do believe he wears a pin that has the number 10 on it. But good job, Todd, tracking down Coach. It was very nice to talk to him.
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune into Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV. Stream for free on BR Live or download the Dan Patrick Show app.